Hello students, we have been dealing about the flower in angiosperms. This is lecture number 10 in morphology of flowering plants. So yesterday I was telling you about, or in the previous class I was telling you about the structure of flower also. A flower is made a reproductive shoot of the angiosperm. It is made up of four floral whorls, namely calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynecium. Among them, calyx and corolla are called accessory whorls of the flower. Andrecium and gynecium are called main whorls of the flower. Okay. Now remember, in this angiospermic flower, we can come across a pedicel like this, stalk of a flower here. Over the tip of the pedicel, this is called pedicel, we can say. The tip of the pedicel is called as thalamus, remember. Thalamus is otherwise known as torus also. Torus is otherwise known as receptacle also, remember. So receptacle, torus, thalamus, they all synonyms. They refer to the tip of the pedicel actually. Above the pedicel or above the tip here in the thalamus, we come across calyx like this. This is the calyx part, we can say. Calyx will be enclosing corolla part like this. There is andrecium containing stamens in this way and gynecium like this. So in the previous lecture, I told you about units of this floral whorl also. Calyx is made up of, what is that, sepals. You may recall, calyx is made up of sepals. Corolla is made up of petals, remember. And here andrecium is made up of stamen. This is called andrecium, male reproductive part of a flower, we can see. And gynecium is present hidden inside here like this. That is the gynecium. Parts of gynecium, I will tell you later. This part is known as gynecium, we can say. Now by understanding these basic ideas about a reproductive shoot, let us go for some terminologies for describing a angiosperm flower. There are certain terminologies to describe the flower, scientific terminologies. So scientific words must be used when we describe a flower. That is known as description of a flower, we can say here. Description of a flower, I am going to discuss here with some terminologies. If you want to describe a flower, vivarane antivala, vivarane flower na vivarane madodidre, you have to use these terminologies actually. Please listen. The first terminology you can remember here is pedicellate flower. Means what? Pedicellate. The flower having pedicel is called pedicellate flower. Pedicel is present means it is known as, what is that, pedicellate flower. In hibiscus, pedicel is present. So it is called pedicellate flower. There are some flowers which do not have pedicel. They don't have pedicel at all. Directly calyx will be attached to the stem or axillary bud like that. Such a flower without pedicel will be known as sessile flower, we can say here. Sessile flower. Sessile flower means pedicel is absent, remember this point. If pedicel is present, it is called pedicellate. If pedicel is absent, it is called a sessile flower. For present, pedicellate flower, example is hibiscus, remember. For sessile flower, you can remember the example from Achyranthus, we can see. Here there is no pedicel, sessile flower it can be called. Okay. When we come to some other terminologies for describing a flower, a flower can be said to be complete flower actually. When it will be said to be a complete flower means what? What is the definition? When a flower has got all four floral whorls in it, all four floral whorls are present means it will be known as a complete flower actually. A flower having calyx, corolla, andrecium, gynecium, all are present means it will be called as complete flower. There is a flower called incomplete flower also. Complete, incomplete. From the name itself, you can understand the point. In an incomplete flower, any one of the floral whorls or two of the floral whorls will be absent. They may not have calyx, or they may not have corolla, they may not have andrecium or gynecium. Any one out of the four whorls, if any one is absent or two are absent, then it will be called an incomplete flower. In the incomplete flower, any one or two floral whorls are absent. If any one or two floral whorls are absent means, it will be known as an incomplete flower, we can see. So these are the basic four terminologies for describing a flower. If it has pedicel, pedicellate. If it does not have pedicel, sessile flower. If it has all the four floral parts, complete flower. If it is not having any one or two floral whorls, it will be called incomplete flower. Let me come to some other terminologies now. Fifth terminology, sixth one, like that, many terminologies we are going to use for describing a flower actually. Let me come to another terminology, the fifth one. Imagine, depending upon the symmetry, we can differentiate a flower into or describe a flower into three types actually. Based upon a phenomenon called symmetry. I will explain this symmetry now, listen to me. There are flowers which are called actinomorphic flowers, they can be called. Actinomorphic flower means what? We have to see here. When a flower is exhibiting radial symmetry, then it will be called as actinomorphic flower, remember. When a flower exhibits radial symmetry, it is called actinomorphic flower. So what is called radial symmetry? Please listen. Symmetry refers to an imaginary line. It is an imaginary line which can divide an organ or organism into two equal parts. Please listen carefully. This word symmetry you will study in animals also, zoology also. What is that symmetry means? It is an imaginary line which will divide an organ or organism into two equal parts. For example, if you take a human body, it can be divided into two equal parts only by means of one plane, we can say. You can divide the human body into two equal parts only by this division or plane of division. If you divide the human body like this, it will not give you equal parts. Do you get my point? Only by a vertical plane you will get two equal parts. Right side, left side, one hand, another hand, like that you can get. But if you divide the human body in horizontal way, you will not get equal parts. So, this type of symmetry, this type of imaginary line. Imaginary line means kalpana rege, it can be called. So in that imaginary line, you will be getting only two equal parts means it is known as bilateral symmetry it can be called. Try to understand this word. Bi means two, lateral means side. So two sides only will get equal parts. But if you take a starfish or if you take an hibiscus flower, imagine hibiscus flower, let us imagine it is also an organism or organ only. Here you can cut the flower by in many planes. Actually this flower will produce equal parts, either like this or like this or like this, in many plane of division they will give you equal parts because they are somewhat spherical. Human body is not spherical, it is elongated. Here it will be spherical outline, so you can cut them into two equal parts in many planes of division. Only one plane of division means bilateral symmetry, in many planes of division means radial symmetry. So the flowers exhibiting radial symmetry are known as actinomorphic flower. This is radial symmetry, it is called actinomorphic flower. Do you get my point? Best example is hibiscus, it exhibits radial symmetry. I will introduce another word, another terminology here. What is known as zygomorphic flower also we have to know here. Zygomorphic flower. Zygomorphic flower means the flower exhibiting bilateral symmetry is known as zygomorphic flower it can be called. There are some flowers which will show bilateral symmetry only. They can be divided in only one plane of division, not many planes. For example, pea flower you can remember. Batani we are telling, you know, that pea flowers. Such flowers will be exhibiting bilateral symmetry. Actinomorphic example you can remember, hibiscus, which is known to us. It is a complete flower like that, and we can see. Then seventh terminology is asymmetric flower it can be called. Asymmetric. For asymmetric flower, there is no symmetry at all, neither in bilateral nor radial symmetry. In none of the plane of division they will give you equal parts. So no symmetry. Symmetry is absent. Then it will be called as asymmetric flower. Symmetry absent. Where do we find as absence of symmetry? Means in some flowers of or in some plants like canna, they exhibit asymmetric flower. So radial symmetry, bilateral symmetry and asymmetry. If no symmetry is possible, neither radial nor zygomorphic, then it will be called asymmetric flower. Example is canna, remember this point. Here I want to tell you another terminology also. An actinomorphic flower can be otherwise known as a regular flower also. Asymmetric flower will be otherwise known as a irregular flower also. Regular, irregular, that word we are using for actinomorphic and asymmetric. For zygomorphic no such word is used. Okay. Similarly, complete, incomplete is different. Regular, irregular is different. So around 7 terminologies I told you so far. Still some more terminologies are there. I will continue this one. Make note. We will continue. Half a minute. कि स्टूडेंट्स यू माइट हैव लर्न्ड दिस टर्मिनोलॉजीज विथ रेफरेंस टू डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ योर फ्लावर हियर. सो व्हेन वी डिस्क्राइब योर फ्लावर वी आर यूजिंग दिस टर्मिनोलॉजीज लाइक एक्टिनोमॉर्फिक, zygomorphic and asymmetric flower like that. Similarly, complete flower, incomplete flower, then pedicellate flower, sessile flower like that. Various terminologies we are going to describe. Right. In addition to that, there is an eighth terminology I will just tell you here, simple one. A flower can be defined or described as a bracteate flower also. It can be described as a bracteate flower. What is a bract? We have to know. Bract refers to a type of leaf-like structure arising at the axil of a flower. At the axil of a flower, this is the stem. Here it pedicel will be there. Here calyx, corolla, gynoecium, andrecium, everything is there. In the axil of this area, here, this is called the axil. In this area, if we come across leaf-like structure, then that leaf-like structure is called the bract, we can see. This is pedicel, this is the bract. Where is the bract present? It is present at the base of the pedicel, not here. Here it is. So that is called bracteate flower. A flower having bracts. So bracteate flower means bracts are present. Then it will be called as what is that? Bracteate flower, we can say here. Okay. Remember, bracts are present. Suppose if bracts are absent, there is no such bract found here means, such a flower will be termed as E-bracteate flower also. E-bracteate flower is used a terminology here. The word E here refers to absence of bract. We should not use A-bracteate flower, it is E-bracteate flower. Bracteate, E-bracteate. E-bracteate flower means bracts are absent. Remember this point. If bracts are absent, then it is called E-bracteate flower. If bracts are present, then it is called bracteate flower. Let me come to another terminology also. A flower can be described as bracteole. Okay, bracteolate flower also. Again, I am going to tell about a bracteole. Please listen. Bracteoles are present in addition to bract actually. There may be some other leaf-like structure present here and all in the pedicel. On the sides of the pedicel, few small leaf-like structures may be present. They are called bracteole. Bract, bracteole. Smaller bract it can be called. That is called bracteoles are present. If bracteoles are present, then we will call it as what is that? Bracteolate flower. If bracteoles are absent, we will call it as E-bracteolate. E-bracteolate flower. What is the meaning? From the name itself you can understand. Here bracteoles are absent. If bracteoles are absent, it is E-bracteole. If bracteoles are present, it is bracteole. Bracts are absent, E-bracteate. Bracts are present, bracteate. Some other simple terminologies we can learn in this category. Let me come to very important, somewhat confusing terminologies here also. The 12th terminology. A flower can be said as a bisexual flower also. Another important terminology I am going to introduce is a bisexual flower. What is a bisexual flower? Sexual refers to andrecium and gynecium. I told you already, calyx and corolla are not main organs. They are not directly involved in sexual reproduction. Only andrecium is the male part, gynecium is the female part. So those andrecium and gynecium are called sexual part, main part. Now remember one point. If a flower has both andrecium and gynecium, then it is called bisexual flower. The flower having both andrecium and gynecium, both andrecium and gynecium is known as bisexual flower. Example, hibiscus. We could come across stamen also and carpel also. Both andrecium and gynecium are present, means it is called bisexual flower. Let me tell you another terminology here. What is called an unisexual flower, we have to see here. Unisexual flower, very important point, try to listen. Uni refers to only one, unicellular, single cell, isn't it? Like that, unisex, only one, that means a flower. Definition for this is a flower having either andrecium, remember the definition here, either andrecium or gynecium is known as unisexual flower, we can use here. Here I am using the word called and. Here we are using or. Either andrecium or gynecium is called unisexual flower. In such a flower, only either andrecium will be present, gynecium will be absent. Or gynecium will be present, andrecium will be absent. We can call it as incomplete flower also, is not? Because any one of the floral whorls are absent. Now, it is a unisexual flower. Dear students, in unisexual flower, there are two types, remember. First type is called staminate flower. Staminate flower. Second type is called pistillate flower, it can be called. There are two types, staminate and pistillate. Staminate flower means male flower. Pistillate flower means female flower, we can say. Male flower means andrecium is present, gynecium is absent here. In male flower, only andrecium will be present. In either andrecium or gynecium, I told you. So in unisexuality, there are two kinds. Andrecium only will be present, gynecium will be absent. In female pistillate flower, only gynecium will be present, andrecium will be absent. Do you get this point? Here, gynecium only will be present, andrecium will be absent. Here, andrecium only is present, gynecium is absent. So male flowers are called staminate, female flowers are called pistillate. Where do they come? They come under the category called unisexuality. What is bisexuality? It is having both andrecium and gynecium. Here they will be either andrecium or gynecium, we can say. There are many examples like a palm tree, even date palm we are telling, no? Gajur like that. They are all coming under this category, staminate and pistillate flowers like that. Even unisexual flowers can be found in plants like maize also. Maize plant has got both male and male flower or female flower like that. Okay, we shall continue further. This 13 terminologies, bracteate, ebracteate, bracteolate, ebracteolate, bisexual, unisexual, everything you remember. After 10 seconds, I will continue further. Make note. Students, let us see some more terminologies for describing a flower here. Some more terminologies which will be useful for some lessons in second year also. Let me continue with 14th terminology here. What is known as monoecious plant we are going to use. Not monoecious flower, monoecious plant I am going to describe here. It is not about flower, it is about a plant we can say. Monoecious. It is a type of, otherwise a plant. It is a plant having both male and female flowers in it. Monoecious means both male and female flowers are present in them. Are you getting my point? Male flowers are called staminate, female flowers are called pistillate. If your plant has got, not about flower, this is plant. If your plant has got both staminate and pistillate flowers in it, then it will be called monoecious plant. Example for that is ficus or fig. Ficus bengalensis we can say. They will have male flower and female flower also, both in the same thing. Imagine in animals also, there are some animals who will have both testes and ovary. Here just like that, a plant having both male and female flowers, staminate and pistillate flower, is called monoecious plant. Similarly, there is another terminology. Dioecious plant also we have to remember. I am writing the definitions here so that you can easily remember, recall. Dioecious plant means a plant having either male flower or female flower in it. So either it will be male plant or it will be a female plant. There will be one plant with male flowers only. There will be one plant with female flowers only. That is called a dioecious condition, it can be called. It is a condition in which male flowers are present in a particular plant, female flowers are present in another particular plant. That is called as dioecious plant, we can say. So either staminate flower or pistillate flower. Here both staminate and pistillate, trying to get the difference. Bisexual, unisexual is about flower. Monoecious, dioecious is about plant, not for about flower. It is a plant body which has got both staminate and pistillate flower. It is the plant body which has got either staminate or pistillate flower. Okay. There is a next condition depending on sexuality of the flowers. These are all about the sexual nature of the flower. The 16th terminology I am explaining here is what is called as a polygamous plant we are going to discuss here. Polygamous plant. From the name itself you can understand. Pali means many, isn't it? Uni means single. Bi or di means two. Now I am talking about polygamous. This is a very important plant. A plant having male, female and bisexual flowers. All the three types of flowers are present in a plant means it is called a polygamous plant. They will have staminate flower, they will have pistillate flower, at the same time they will have bisexual flower also. If your plant is having the all the three types of flower, in some areas there will be only male plant, in that same plant. In some areas there will be only female, in other areas there will be both sexes, bisexual. So all the three are present, male, female, bisexual, all the three are present means it is called a polygamous. Polygamous example is mango, you can remember. In this plant, some flowers will be male, some flowers will be female, some will be bisexual also. So that is polygamous plant. 16 terminologies I told you. This among them, these five terminologies are depending on sexuality of the flower. Bisexual, unisexual. In unisexual, staminate and pistillate. Please remember, staminate flower is an incomplete flower because it does not have gynoecium. Pistillate flower is also an incomplete flower because it does not have androecium. But this may be a complete flower, I can say. So remember these terminologies, monoecious, dioecious and polygamous. Please make note, we will continue. Try to grasp these terminologies. Why I am giving a gap means you have to understand, assimilate these terminologies. Okay, just. Students, we shall continue with some more terminologies here. Listen. There are three more terminologies. I think 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 I told you. Let me tell you about 17th terminology here. Okay? Just listen. Very simple terminologies only. What is called as A. Chlamydias flower. A. Chlamydias flower. Listen, A. Chlamydias flower means in this flower there will be no calyx, no corolla. Accessory floral whorls will be absent. The flower which does not have accessory floral whorl will be called A. Chlamydias flower. The flower where calyx and corolla are absent, that is called as A. Chlamydias flower, we can say. They will directly have androecium and gynoecium only. Whereas there is another terminology we have to remember, monochlamydias flower. Monochlamydias flower also we have to learn here. In the case of monochlamydias flower, mono means single, they will be not what is that? Either calyx or corolla will be present. Remember this point. Either calyx or corolla. Either calyx or corolla will be present here. I am sorry. Corolla is present means then it will be called as what is that? Monochlamydia flower. Any one only. Mono means single only. Chlamydia refers to accessory one. Let me come to another terminology here. What is called homochlamydious spelling? Homochlamydious flower. Homochlamydious flower. What is meant by homochlamydious flower? Homo means similar, isn't it? Similar. Where calyx and corolla cannot be differentiated. There will be accessory bulb, but you cannot say which is calyx, which is corolla. Both may be green in color. Both will appear simple only. So, calyx and corolla cannot be differentiated. Cannot be differentiated means it will be called as what is that? Homochlamydious flower. Cannot be. You cannot say which is calyx, which is corolla. Both will be green colors only. If that is the case, how will we call it? Whether to call it as calyx or corolla means we use the terminology called perianth to describe a homochlamydious flower. In homochlamydious flower, you should not call it as calyx or corolla because they cannot be differentiated. So we have to use the word perianth. For perianth, which is the unit, tepals, we have tepals. Sepals are there, petals are there. Now I am going to tell you about tepals. So that is called perianth, we can say here. Next one is 20th terminology I am going to discuss here. It is known as heterochlamydious flower. Heterochlamydious flower we have to know here. From the name itself you can understand hetero refers to dissimilar or different. Homo means similar. Hetero means dissimilar. Where calyx and corolla can be differentiated. They can be differentiated. In hibiscus, we can come across calyx and corolla differently. Calyx will be green in color. Corolla will be pink in color or red in color. But in perianth, nothing will be there. Tepals. Where do we find a perianth means? In plants like lily plant, we come across a homochlamydious nature. Where tepals are present, perianth is present. You cannot call them as calyx or corolla because they are not differentiated. Monochlamydious flower, either calyx or corolla only will be present. In some of the monocots, we come across these kind of conditions. Remember, absence of calyx, absence of corolla, they can also be found in the case of some aquatic plants or hydrophytes, we can say. So these are some terminologies related to a flower. For describing a flower, we use around 20 terminologies. Here, achlamydious, monochlamydious, homochlamydious, heterochlamydious. All of them are depending upon calyx and corolla only. In the previous part, I told you about sexuality of the flower. Unisexual, bisexual, staminate, then pistillate, then monoecious plant, dioecious plant, that is another set. That is with reference to andrecium and gynecium. This is with reference to chlamydia, calyx and corona. Just make note. After 5 seconds, I will continue. Just go through it. So students, you have to go through all the 20 terminologies. Each one is worthy of one more question. They will be asking one more question in the board exam also. Not only that, after in the later part of this lesson, we are going to describe about angiosperm families. There we will be using these terminologies again. So directly when we use the word monochlamydia, you should not, you should be knowing about the terminology easily. This is the important termin, these are important terminologies for describing a flower. We shall continue. So yeah, this flower can be described on the basis of their symmetry, on the basis of their andrecium and gynecium, and on the basis of calyx and corolla. Similarly, we can call them as complete, incomplete flower and basic terminologies. Make note of these words, try to imbibe these points. We will continue later in the next class. Thank you.